The singer's formant? What does that mean? What is that? Is that some special muscle or some special bone that the singers have? Or what is the singer's formant?
Dukadua!
Hey folks, I'm Voba. I'm a singer and a vocal trainer, and this is my channel about anatomical vocal training. The singer's formant. Some people and some voice teachers talk about a certain vibration in the voice that singers can produce. Yes, it's not something that singers have. It's something that singers can learn to produce. Specifically, it is a frequency in the voice that you can learn to increase the volume of. So every note has overtones, and certain overtones at a certain range are very specific to the voice. There is no other acoustic instrument that can increase these overtones at that range of hertz, or at that overtone range. So therefore it's very specific to the singer, and the singer can be heard through any type of other instruments that don't have that particular frequency in there. I showed already a lot of how to sing louder in this video that kind of like gives you the introduction. Now today I want to show the singer's formant in a frequency analyzer in combination with me singing a few things, and you can see here what the difference, how it sounds differently, and you can see it on the graph, hopefully, what the difference is. I'm going to use only head voice because it's easier. If I put too many other muscles in, it's going to be confusing. I really just want you to listen and hear the difference between without the singer's formant being amplified and with the singer's formant being amplified. Now the singer's formant is created in the space between the vocal cords and the vocal folds, called the ventricle. That if that ventricle, it's like a little sack of meat sack. It's like a space between those two, that if it opens, it adds a frequency, it adds more volume to the frequencies at around 2800 to 3200 hertz of your overtones that every voice has. Again, if you don't know what I'm talking about, refer to that video there. I explain in detail what that means, the overtones, and you know. So today I'm going to sing a bit and show you the difference between the ventricle not being very open and then the ventricle being opened, so the singer's formant can be amplified in your voice. First song. Now with the singer's formant, you see how the overtone frequencies at around 3000 to 100, 200 hertz are raised more with this space opened rather than without it. Another classical example. It's difficult actually to not put the singer's formant in, because I really have to focus on keeping my throat up so that the space doesn't open. Let me try again. With the singer's formant. Ombra, my fool. how the overtones again are elevated, they are raised. Of course, you can also have that in more popular music. Sometimes I feel like a motherless child. Sometimes I feel like a motherless child. With ventricle open. Sometimes I feel like a motherless child. Sometimes I feel like a motherless child. Sometimes I feel like a motherless child. A long way from home. For instance, so you see, obviously, in classical singing, the overtone frequencies are raised higher, potentially, than in modern singing, just because your thyroid cartilage usually goes deeper and you can therefore have the space opened up between the vocal cords and the vestibular folds so that this resonance can really gain momentum. Now, for modern music, if you start using a more chesty sound, you can of course also open up the space, and it will sound very modern. Most people think, oh no, low thyroid cartilage, that's just for classical singers, I'm a pop singer, I don't do that. But if you really want to have like a whoosh voice, yeah, you can do that too. And it doesn't have to sound classical when you actually put your thyroid cartilage down and open that space up. It always depends on how much sharpness you put in and really how you use the words more, rather than just whether your thyroid cartilage is down or not. But I will make a video in detail about that in the future. For today, just go home with the knowledge that you have the space in between the vocal cords and the vestibular folds that you can open, and through opening your voice will have an added resonance, added in volume. It's always there, but you can raise the volume of that frequency, that particular frequency, between 2800 and 3200 hertz, where your voice can just carry much further. It can just carry over a whole orchestra, not because you push and you sing so loud, but because you open up the space, the resonance right here, not anywhere here, right here between your vocal cords and vocal folds, right there. I hope that input was helpful for you. If you like my video, please like my video and subscribe to my channel. Have a wonderful, brilliantly overtony day with your newfound knowledge about the singer's formant.